Hey guys, welcome back to another video again with Simply GCV. So guys, here is another video again on choral obedience. So I already have that video on my channel here where Justin was saying that he never laid hands on Cora, he never abused her, but has he ever used, you know, abusive words on her, harsh words on her? Yes, he has, because she provoked him, but he never laid hands on her. So here in this video, Cora was here to address that his phrase. And according to Cora, she says that Justin has beaten her, he has slapped her, he yanked her, and you know, as when she was even pregnant, and 2 days or a day after that, she lost her pregnancy. So Cora lost a pregnancy before Athena's pregnancy due to Justin's, you know, abuse. And here he is on social media saying the opposite of what he usually do. The thing is that, guys, for me, the way I see Justin, like I always say, he's just on social media, you know, just to accumulate the, you know, to get the fans. But he's not really bringing out his true self, his real color, out to social media. So it's still difficult for people to really understand who he is. But the thing is that, now that Cora is beginning to speak, many people are getting to know the real Justin thing. You guys know. So, and I would say that anyone that is really attacking Cora should just take her time and listen to her. Take her to time and hear her. Listen to her when she's doing her live video. She may be joking or she may be laughing and all of that, but see guys, it is not easy on her. Cora is passing through a lot. I mean, she's going through so much, and I know that she's just putting up with all of this just because of her kids, you know, putting on that smiling face as if all is well. But hey, we are all humans, all is not well. But the most important thing is that she's beginning to speak up. That's another great way of healing inside as well. Not to bottle everything inside. It's very important. So you guys are going to watch her and hear from her how she has been, you know, abused and how she lost a pregnancy due to the man that she lived with and called her husband. This is Simply GCV, guys. I'll be seeing you guys on my next upload. Bye.
There is fire on the mountain, guys. I want to clear out something that you guys have been bringing to my attention. He posting something saying that this is evidence that he never abused me. Justin slapped me at 3 months pregnant in the face. Justin, I lost the pregnancy before I had Athena.
I don't know why you guys are asking me about this. I came all the way to LA to come and help my sister.
3 days before, I lost that pregnancy. Okay. He yanked me, and I called my father on the phone, and my father said I should leave the house, I should calm down. We were having an argument, he yanked me, 3 days later I bled, and I lost the pregnancy. Yeah. I told you I would bring it out small, right? I've just been keeping quiet, but now, small, you guys don't know. When I lost this pregnancy, of course, naturally, as every woman would, we have an argument. We've been fighting nonstop. And you yanked me. I was about to leave the house. You yanked me and pulled me by my shoulder. I, of course, blamed it on him. I said, hey, I think that it was because of our constant arguing. That's why I lost this pregnancy. And then I told my father that I think it's because of our constant arguing. And when he physically yanked me when I was about to leave the room, that I lost this pregnancy. In that text that he posted, he only posted the part where I said, how do I tell you that I asked you, that the prelude of that text message was, and I quote, how do I tell my father that you did not yank me, you only tapped me, you did not slap me, you only tapped me like a baby's butt. You know, this is what an abused woman would do. Oh, he didn't beat me, he only tapped me, he didn't yank me, and that's what I was telling Justin. You didn't tap me. how do I tell my father that? Let's just let it rest. Let's just let it lie down and let us just forget about all of this. Let's just let peace reign. This was him telling me to tell my family that he didn't abuse me. I should tell my family that he didn't touch me. But he did.
So I'm trying to make eggs.
And now he's putting that up as his evidence that he didn't touch me.
Alright.
But the only reason why I don't have the chat before that to post is because you broke my phone. So I don't even have the chats. Cora, please, enough talk for now. You're making him restless and building up more lies. I saw him tagging Instablog Nigeria. Come, reach out to me. Instablog, reach out to me.
He's desperate, man.
He's desperate to show the world, to cover his tracks. But I'm not keeping quiet anymore.
You guys, I'm making eggs. I'm going to put the eggs right very soon. Just seasoning some vegetables.
By the way, it's Nancy's kitchen.
What?
But the person who was always there, after every slap, after every fight, after everything was nasty, and she had to block us at some point. She was like, boundaries, guys, I have my own family. Yes, he's asking Instablog to reach out to him. It's crazy, it's funny. I don't need to tag Instablog or anything. I'm just here to speak my own truth and let it rest. It's fine. When everybody was calling me, Ashewo, you cheat, Abi, you know cheat, hey. Nobody knew that he cheated.
Yes, he has to tag his blog. I mean, he wants somebody's country blog to help take down his wife. Imagine. So that in the future, it will be, Instablog published something. If anything, it will be his affair that they will tag, they will collect.
And he's trying to deny the affair. It's what it's worth.
He's denying the affair. Somebody that was saying that she wanted to come to LA to be with you. Promised her everything. You promised her you were getting a divorce. And then you came back and impregnated your wife. And I said, oh, sorry, it was a mistake. And then she was heartbroken. And then now you're like, ooh.
Why did you not impregnate me if it was a mistake?
Such a mistake. And now the Athena that he's kissing and rubbing every day.
Oh, my Athena. My Athena. Hey, was a mistake to his girlfriend.
How are you doing, guys? My one is that in this life, everything should be equal.
Keep your drama to yourself. This is for only dollars and attention. Hey, Karen. Hi. No, this is not for dollars and attention. Unlike you, I am here to remove the smear from my reputation that has been done by my smear campaigner, aka Justin the Narcissist. And I am trying to clean up my name. I have been quiet for the longest time. Now I'm speaking. And this is not for dollars. Mm-mm. This is not for drama. Mm-mm. If anything, I'm always like, please, I don't want drama. But he already put it out there. This is me on my knees, kneeling down to my husband. Please, don't put our divorce public. He did what he did.
No, but what's stopping someone from divorcing? If she did all these things, why can't you just...
divorce in peace and go? Must you go and call me all sorts of things in public? And then you were even having an affair.
It's rejection. Now, the thing is, all the mental health advocates here, you guys, I'm sure you can see this is textbook, right? You can see this is textbook, everything, all the disorders people are giving him on Facebook. You can see how everything is playing out. Yes, good parenting is amazing, but it's unfair when only one side is being smeared all the time. And if he continues talking, she will continue to come out and she will continue to
debunk it, because debunk, I'm not going to keep quiet. I'm not the sacrificial lamb that his reputation is going to be destroyed.
She will continue debunking. She can't just come and destroy someone's reputation overnight. Because you are the wife there, everybody will listen to you. We're in a country full of
colonized people that
worship you. So everything you say must be true. It must be the woman that is lying, the black woman. Oh my God, opportunist.
And the one that is always twerking online. I knew she was a slut from the get-go.
He knows the advantage he has. So he's using it very well.
But now, I'm
going to tell you a country's blog. Reach out to me. Let me destroy your country woman. Reach out to me, please. Here you go.
Instablog, reach out to me. Now. Anyway. I'm no longer quiet.
Hey,
Instablog,
please reach out to him, because he needs somebody to help him do his work. Please reach out to him, because Instablog. Instead of them, like,
I was always saying, the battle is not mine, the battle is the Lord's, the battle is not mine.
Their issue goes online. People are like, can you people rest?
Rest, panicking. But now I'm cleaning up my reputation. They're still saying rest.
No, panic. I don't tell people to rest when it's time to clear up their name. You should have told him to rest when he was destroying it. You should have told him, okay, we go rest. Oh, you were like, everyone's giving us attention. Oh my God, we must be so special. Let him talk. He needs to talk. Men have their own feelings too. They need to voice out. He's been holding it inside. And this is Zeus of a guy. What's that guy's name again? Like, I don't even remember. I don't want to call him out.
Don't call anybody's name and give them any clout, please.
My goodness.
He doesn't deserve it.
It's soon gone. I don't want to show it now because it doesn't look so fantastic.
It's not your cook.
It needs to cook.
You can't even leave with the egg, eh?
What are you eating with it? I don't know.
Yeah. Got my voice back. I've got my voice back.
So even after I've gone back, because nobody's going to bully you anymore. That's why I flew all the way. You know how much tickets is? You know how much tickets be?
I'm hiding behind my sister.
Please, Paco, my sister. You have seen a therapist. See, you guys, when you're going through abuse, see a therapist, okay? See a therapist. Make sure that you find someone to talk to. And if all the therapists are saying the same thing, I mean, it's really sad. Imagine someone that is just a chiropractor arguing with me about public health. Argue with me about mental health. Person that doesn't know anything about mental health. Trying to force the diagnosis down someone's throat. You were the one with the diagnosis.